Hi, Assalamualaikum. My name is Kamaru Arifin bin Cik Pemudin. Today, I'm going to talk about the criteria of an ideal teacher. An ideal teacher is the one we respect from our heart. The teacher acts as a guide to the students while not pushing them too much. The teacher is the one who displays self-confidence and is as good as the information he or she has to deliver to the students. If everyone in the world gets an ideal teacher, he or she won't have to look back in his or her life ever. There are few points of view of the criteria of an ideal teacher. My first point of view, an ideal teacher is one who can be a motivator to her students, with the awareness that the students come from different backgrounds, have different personalities, and so on. An ideal teacher should know how to give a motivation to each student. He or she needs to know that different students require different kinds of motivation, as they would definitely face different kinds of problems. He or she always tries the best level to fulfill them. So, being a good motivator is essential to be an ideal teacher. I also think an ideal teacher should be an idol for the students. Some say that teachers are children's role model. Thus, based on this, an ideal teacher should know how to act, dress, speak, walk, or even talk correctly in front of her students. An ideal teacher leaves a lifelong impression on his or her students and impacts their minds in a positive way. He or she always has good personal hygiene and is well groomed. He or she also must have good sense of humor, but his or her fun is not of impolite nature. For all these aspects are actually being observed by them. Other than that, an ideal teacher is patient. Being patient is often expressed as being diligent. Teacher also needs to know how to be less egoistic. It is common for humans to think that they are right even if the others have told them they are wrong. Nevertheless, to be an ideal teacher, one should know to admit his or her mistakes in front of the students. For instance, if the teacher is teaching a wrong thing and one student rises and corrects him or her, the teacher must accept that with an open mind and heart. This is actually how a teacher can improve himself or herself, hence leading to be an ideal teacher before the student's eyes. Besides, an ideal teacher usually has an observer on his or her subject. He or she always knows fully the contents of the subject which he or she has to teach and constantly reading and upgrading themselves in the subject. An ideal teacher is diversified with regard to his preparation. This means that the teacher not only focuses on specific areas but has considerable command on the related subject. Last but not least, one important criterion of an ideal teacher that I believe is all teachers must have is being loved and caring towards the students. Students need that crucial love and care from their teachers, especially those who do not get this at home. Simply asking them if they are fine or simply treat them a meal once in a while is sufficient to portray our love and care towards them. This would definitely make them appreciate us more. In conclusion, there are many ways to be an ideal teacher. There are also many views of how an ideal teacher should be. As I mentioned before, these are only my point of view. Therefore, it's up to the people should be and to evaluate what is an ideal teacher should be. That's all. Thank you.